Place you would not want to come to. High crime and misdemeanor, burnt out cars, gangsters roaming the streets. You'd be lucky if you got out alive, and that's true, absolutely true. But a great lady came along, and she said, I want to buy that beautiful building on the corner and make my foundation and an art center, so that artists will have a place to exhibit. And she did that. And she worked with the local police and the community members. And as a result, she started transforming the community. She is what they call a transformational leader. And within a few years, people began to recognize that. People came from all over the world to see the Arts Center. More artists started moving into the area, and with the artists came businesses, until finally, a few years after that, the government officials began to recognize this, and Howard Golan, then borough president, said, Yuko Nee, that's her name, Yuko Nee, by her activities, has transformed all the northern part of Brooklyn. Wow. And then Governor Pataki came along and named her one of the state's women of the year and said that indeed she has done remarkable things. And accolades began to follow after that. Governor Cuomo, I forget all the other governors' names, but also the mayors, Mayor Bloomberg, Mayor de Blasio recently, and even her alma mater, Pratt Institute, another great art school, gave her an achievement award saying she has done just incredibly remarkable things. Now, I'm not going to talk any more about her. I'm just going to introduce her. Yuko Nee, please come forward.
Thank you very much. Terence Lindor is the president and executive director of the WAR Center. My name is Yuko Nee, I'd like to welcome you all to a wonderful MFA and aluminum show by SUNY, the New Poles. And then thank you very much, Matthew. Today is Saturday, but Friday. And then he used to live in this neighborhood for many, many years, but you are very lucky to have him as your professor. And I can see how productive and creative your students are. Thank you very much for all of your creative artists here to bring great works, and congratulations for your master's degrees. This is sure, isn't it? You're going to graduate very soon. Okay, so we call this Williamsburg Art and Historical Center, acronym WAH Center, W-A-H Center. WAH Center, WAH means in Japanese peace, harmony, and unity. So through the international language of art, you come to understand each other, you come to appreciate each other, and you love each other. So this is the entire motto, a mission statement, and also we happen to be right next to the Williamsburg Bridge. So we bridge between you and me, between men and women, between young and old, between fine art and performing art, between local, international, national, all disciplines in the art come to the WAH Center. So here we are, we have 50 students, remarkable. So Matthew Friday and put such a great effort, and then together with his associate, congratulations everybody. And here is Matthew, please come. And then
thank you so much, Yuko. And yes, I lived here about 20 years ago in Greenpoint, just a ways down Bedford. It was long enough ago that I still had some hair. And I used to come up here frequently, and got to know Yuko a little bit. And this always impressed me, not just an amazingly beautiful and historic building, but it's one of the truly accessible art centers. And Yuko was, and all of the WAH staff is just amazingly friendly and generous and interested in giving back to the local community. So we're really thrilled to be able to participate in an exhibition at such a fantastic center. I wanted to just thank all of the fantastic graduate students, the current ones, and our alumni who participate in this exhibition, the faculty and the staff who have come to be a part of this as well. If you're not familiar with New Paltz, we are, as I like to say, the largest and the best MFA program within the State University of New York system. It is a fantastic and beautiful center with amazing facilities. Just an hour and a half north of here. I encourage you to come up. And we have a number of our brochures at the table there, so please grab them. There's one for each of our five different studio areas: printmaking, painting and drawing, sculpture, metal, ceramic. Am I forgetting someone? That's it. But please check it out, and I'd be happy to talk to you more about our programs. We're really thrilled with this particular exhibition because it was curated by Shannon Stratton, who is the chief curator at the Museum of Arts and Design. And she wrote a really lovely and generous catalog essay for us. And we have free catalogs. I'd like to encourage you to grab some. They're at the table up there. Please, you know, take one. They're for you. And I wanted to read just a little bit of her intro essay because I think her words really describe the core logics of the exhibition here. So she says, the work of these artists isn't necessarily optimistic, but it's not dire either. In fact, the empathy that much of the work communicates for the environment, for animals, for ancestors, for neighbors, for strangers, is almost hopeful. Even if the work itself is a harbinger for social and political dangers that our current global condition portends. Rather than projecting messages, announcing, or even yelling at their audiences, this group has mined either the personal and the poetic, even if it's occasionally angry or hurt, or tune into the tenor of the moment. They are antennas, perhaps, unable to channel the currents swirling around them as they emerge in the midst of both great social and political divisions in the United States and a moment of immense political awakening. So that's just a little bit from her essay, and I certainly recommend the rest of it for reading, because it's quite fantastic. The title from the exhibition came between a dialogue from Shannon and I, and we like the idea of the pause is something that's necessary, like a moment of reflection to sort of think, to digest, to reflect before taking action. And also, of course, the notion of press, the tactile nature of touching up against something, of exchanging qualities and capabilities with people, with objects. So we thought press pause was really both a call for immediate reflection, but a call for exchange with each other. So thank you all for coming, and thanks again to Yuko for allowing us to participate in this wonderful space.
All right, a little bit late to give him bouquet of flowers, but this meant to be all of you who are going to graduate, and then tiny little bit of flowers, but it meant to be big. And congratulations for the wonderful show. And what about beautiful ladies here? What is your name?
Sylvia.
Say that SUNY New Paltz has an amazingly expansive program in metal, ceramic, printmaking, painting and drawing, and sculpture. And the work that's on display here is reflective of all of these different areas. Our students are, of course, really interested in interdisciplinary approaches and have a wide array of technical and conceptual disciplines and interests as well. And we're really excited to be able to participate in the in an exhibition here at the Williamsburg Arts and Historical Center. It's an absolutely fantastic and beautiful space, and we're very honored to have a show here. Thanks.
Thanks. So,
that's good.
Thank you. Thank you.